Hi, this is Sarah Meixel with thecropsite.com, and we're reporting live from the Commodity Classic down in Orlando, Florida. Today we're with Jeff Springsteen. He works with the herbicide group at Bayer Crop Science, and let's talk a little bit more about weed resistance. And we've been talking about some of the other components to it, what caused it, but now let's talk a little bit about the economics of it. And how much does it cost, looking at the U.S., for example, right, what's the cost to the guy in the South versus the guy in the Midwest, where, you know, we see that weed resistance creeping north?
Well, and I think that's the, you know, Sarah, one of the keys is whatever the dollars are, U.S. or anywhere else, it's the exponential growth that you see in the cost when you have resistant weeds. If we look at the days when people were just using glyphosate once or twice a year,
right,
you know, they were spending $10 to $15 an acre. Yeah. You know, nirvana in those
days,
right? They paying hardly anything. Today, already in the Midwest, if you look at soybeans, growers are paying $30 to $40 an acre, right?
Uh-huh.
And that's when you have just some resistance and glyphosate just not working as well anymore. But you head further south and you head down into that, you know, Arkansas, Tennessee, area, you know, they're spending anywhere from $70 to $120 per acre to be able to get efficient control. Or, you know, one farm I went to last year, we were on our weed resistance tour. The farmer had a cutting crew, a hoe crew, come through twice already that year.
Oh, my God.
And you looked at it, and it would probably not be acceptable in the Midwest as far as weed control was concerned. So we kind of said that, you know, so you spend all this money. And he said, well, look at that field over there. I did not have a cutting crew come through, and you could not even see the soybeans.
Wow.
It just looked like they had planted Palmer amaranth.
Oh, my God.
And these Palmer amaranth, I'm a tall guy, and they were taller than me.
Wow.
And the seed heads on these things were huge. So you can just imagine how many more seeds are going to be out there for the next year. So, yeah.
Those kind of fields probably aren't even harvestable, are they?
No.
When it gets so when it just takes over, I mean, it's beyond repair, right?
Oh, definitely. And probably one of the other big issues that we're seeing today is, I don't know, last year we actually started to see some Palmer amaranth, which is usually a southern weed,
right,
starting to pop up in places like Minnesota, Michigan, and Wisconsin.
So
how is it getting up there?
Yeah.
Dairy feed. They're bringing up the feed from the south,
right,
and in it is the weed seed, because it's so prevalent.
Right.
It's now getting out into fields up in the northern part of the U.S. And that's the scary part is, you know, water hemp is extremely tough as a weed,
right,
but Palmer amaranth makes water hemp look easy to control. So we don't want that thing throughout
right,
the U.S. or, you know, even kochia. I was up in North Dakota this year,
right,
looking at some kochia fields, and it's amazing, you know, to when you can't see the soybeans or you can't see the corn,
mm-hmm,
because the weeds are taller and thicker than the actual crop is.
That's just amazing. And so we know this from the U.S. perspective. And globally, you have to assume that it's the same types of situations that they're dealing with, right?
No doubt about it. You know, so, you know, do you want to spend today, let's say, you know, the $20 to $30 or $30 to $40, or do you want to spend that $70 to $120 in the future? So, you know, you need to do that today. And, you know, whether you're looking at acres or
right,
hectares or
right,
or whatever it is, the key point is the worse it gets, the more it's going to cost you, whether it be in cutting crews coming through to actually hoe out the weeds, or if it means that you're going to have to put two or three or four applications,
mm-hmm,
on the acre to try to control the weeds.
It's just so hard to imagine these people coming in and hoeing through a field. I mean, in the Midwest here, it seems crazy to even imagine, but I know they're doing it down in the South.
Oh, and we have our respective rotation tours where we try to we are educating farmers about weed resistance, and actually that's one of the props we use.
Yeah.
You know, is we, you know, hold a hoe and say, you know, this is your future.
Yeah.
If you do not take care of weed resistance today, you know, this is something that maybe you're not going to use, but you're going to be paying people
right,
to use in your fields, because you're not going to be able to, like you said before, just not harvest the crop, right?
Right.
So you're going to have to, if the herbicides are not working anymore, the only thing that's left is to actually have people either cultivate it out or have people come in and hoe it out.
And the solution really really is rotating your chemistry, right?
Oh, definitely, no doubt. It's rotating your chemistry, or what's probably even more important is utilizing multiple modes of action, mm-hmm. or using multiple chemistries
right.
on that acre. So if you have a soybean field, use three modes of action. Use four modes of action. You know, make sure that you get enough different types of chemistries on that acre that you're going to kill that weed.
And then if you do have some of these resistant weeds pop up, make sure you clear out the field of them at that point, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we talk to farmers that practice zero tolerance, and that's probably one of the things that's really important, too. Don't wait till you're harvesting. Don't wait till you're combining to see
right.
what your weeds are. You know, whether you have a scout that does it for you or you do it for you, make sure that you are watching that field throughout the season. And if you see those weeds out there, you know, get them out of the field, especially if you're looking at a water hemp or a farmer amaranth or a kochia.
What is the timing for when the seed spreads, you know?
Oh, I mean,
that's the end of the season,
yeah,
right?
Typically it's going to be right around harvest time.
Right.
I mean, when we went out on our weed resistance tour, it was in August. And I found out that I am allergic to kochia pollen because I felt like I had a massive flu from inhaling all that kochia pollen in the air. So yeah, August, September.
That's when it's spreading the seed, right?
Yep. And you know, I can just imagine what it's going to look like up there next year because it was pretty bad this year with all that pollen, you know, kochia seed pollen flying everywhere.
Sure.
It's just going to be a lot worse.
Thanks so much for your time today. We really appreciate it.
Well, thank you, sir.
Thanks. This is Sarah Meitzel reporting from the Commodity Classic.